13 kills and 3 aces, back-to-back aces, to end the match last night against the Crimson. On the opposite side, for the Wildcats, a big win over the number 12 UCSB, the second-ranked win in program history. They beat number 12 CSUN last year, so they're undefeated against number 12-ranked teams in the country. As we get underway here at the MAC, and almost a pancake save on the near side, the Wildcats will pick up the first point. Damon went through the middles in the matchup yesterday. This is back set for Schneider, and got a piece. So level at 1-1 after Zach Schneider had a phenomenal start to the match yesterday, but cooled down. It was Cameron Milligan who really took the team on his shoulders with 17 kills, hit 333 in the matchup. As a team, Wildcats hit 212 with 57 kills. That's right down Broadway, taken by Cameron Thorne. Middle blocker, sophomore from Hollywood, Florida. Thorne also had a good start to the matchup yesterday for the Lopes. 5 kills for Thorne. Taking the serve, there was Hickman. And fought for through the block. It's gonna land out of play, so the point there for Damon. All tied up at 2-2 here in the opening set. Grand Canyon in the midst of a 6-match road trip with a trio of matches coming here on the East Coast. They defeated Merrimack 3-1 before sweeping Harvard last night. There's a powerful strike dug out on the back row. Set up for Schneider. Schneider looking for a piece. Did he get it off the block? No, the block was disciplined there for the Lopes. And they'll keep their hands at bay. There on 2. Little tap back over here for the Wildcats. Another strong strike off the block. It was taken by Cameron Milligan. And Milligan's gonna pick up the point. Milligan with 17 kills last night. Billy Wieberg also picking up a career performance. His first career double-double with 12 kills and 11 digs in the matchup. Damon's gonna regain the lead here. So good movement, quick opportunities here for the Wildcats. They have taken a couple of chances here from number 2, GCU. Good dig on the back row, right down and taken. It was Rico Wardlow, the senior, who gets the point. Actually, that was wide, it's called wide. It looked like Wardlow might have gotten a piece there from the block, but instead it just misses on the outside, and now it's tied at 4-4, so Damon staying in it. Another good play here on the near side. Free ball comes back for the Wildcats. And Kruger was the one that saved that one. That's gonna land out of play, and now the Wildcats take the lead 5-4 here in the opening set. Damon coming in 3-1 on the season. 2-0 at home, 0-1 on the road. They picked up their first neutral site victory with the win yesterday. Number 1 in the conference in the NEC, and aces number 2 in the country. They can really serve the ball well. This is back set on the near side and blocked right down. It looked like Milligan with some help there from Andra Arabaz, in a 2-point lead here in the opening set for the Wildcats. Riding the hot serve of Sean Califf, fifth year from Oak Park, Illinois, excuse me. Setter came over from Purdue of Fort Wayne. Another strong one, but that one hits off the net, gives the point right back to the Lopes, and now Grand Canyon with a chance to go on serve. Service error there, gives the point back, now a chance. Off the serve, it's just gonna miss there. Another opportunity for Damon to build off of this 2-point lead. Grand Canyon 8-0 on the year, number two in the country. Playing out of the MPSF. That one's gonna miss long on the serve. Another service error, so we exchange points here. Coming in first in the conference this weekend at 8-0. They're ahead of Stanford, Pepperdine, UCLA. UCLA a little bit of a rough start. Back-to-back losses to Penn State. Dropped them in the rankings and dropped them in the conferences. Now GCU strings together two straight points to level this one at 7-7 here in the opening set. Well, if there's one thing about the Wildcats that we learned yesterday is they will not go away quietly. Took extra points in set number two to build a 2-0 lead over UC Santa Barbara. That one went 28-26. And the final set, 16-14. That one, another big hit there from Rico Wardlow. Wardlow coming into the weekend, 41 kills, a hit percentage at 547. Collected 8 kills with no errors on 11 attempts earlier this year in the win against UC Santa Barbara. It was a 3-1 victory. This one at the net, trying to push it over. Taken on the back set. Now another denial by the block and trying to keep it alive was Carter Rogers. Couldn't get there. Good hustle play from Carter Rogers, the junior from Denver, Colorado. Outside hitter was on the back row. Serve will come from Arabaz, a freshman from Czech Republic, number 12 in the country in blocks per set. And that one gets a service ace as it lands in. Arabaz with 1.11 blocks per set, number 2 in the NEC, 12th in the country. Sean Califf not too far behind, 3rd in the conference at 0.85. Arabaz back on the service line. That one hits off the tape. Diving save by Rogers. And that one goes cross court. Taken by Hickman. And Jackson Hickman's trying to get involved here. Outside hitter from Phoenix, Arizona. Started the season with just seven attacking errors. Hit 442. And 3 road wins at the A6 Invitational. Grand Canyon winning the A6 Invitational. There's going to be a big serve and a point for GCU. Wardlow, who has a strong serve, good running start to get him going. Wardlow, an AVCA All-American for the first time. Honorable mention list a year ago. Now right down the middle. Nice save with the quick hands from Gianni. That one's going to go out of play. Another point here for the Lopes. We talked about Camden Gianni and the day he had yesterday with 13 kills, the 3 aces to end the match. 6 aces in total for the Lopes. Cameron Thorne is behind Gianni on the team in aces with 6 coming into today. Another strong strike, but the block is there. The trio block. Hickman along with Thorne has State holding the top spot in college volleyball. Rico Wardlow back on the service line. Let's put together a run here for the Lopes. Kruger is going to set it up. A strong hit, was looking for a tip, and it looks like Zach Snyder is going to get it. So Damon stops the run there on the powerful strike from Zach Snyder, the Lockport, New York native, at 9 kills, 3 aces against the Buckeyes in that season opener. Serve's gonna come from the Wildcats. And so you, Damon, 17-7 a year ago. They finished 11-3 in NEC play in the inaugural season of the NEC. Finished number 2 in the conference before falling to the 3rd seed LIU in a clean sweep. Don Gleason, 65 wins. In his career, it took over as head coach in 2019. They continue to win as that serve goes long from Snyder. Back in 22-23, had 16 wins, made it to the IVA tournament. Picked up a couple of wins before falling in the finals to Lincoln Memorial. Schneider again hits it off the block. This time he gets the point. Zach Schneider trying to ride the hot hand, the reigning NEC Player of the Year. First team all NEC selection from a year ago. Trying to stay in it here against the number two ranked team in the country, the Grand Canyon Antelopes. Trying to stay undefeated on the year. Trying to keep it alive with Schneider on the back row, but that one's hit down by Thorne. GCU hitting 231 here in this opening set. They've built a three-point lead. A couple of aces for the Lopes. Another chance here on the near side. Milligan, that one's gonna hit off the block and out of play. Cameron Milligan, the senior, trying to find some momentum on the near side. And see the Wildcats bench, they're loving it. Maverick O'Neal back to serve. That one gets over, back to the far side, taken by Rogers. Miss hit there on the setup. Looked like Maverick O'Neal didn't cleanly get it off the hands and couldn't put it towards the top row. O'Neal, a junior from Amherst, New York, had 8 kills, 3 blocks, and 3 digs against the Buckeyes. Califf back right down the middle. That's a hard hit ball, unable to take it was Nick Slight. So another big point there for the Wildcats. It comes through the middle this time. A couple of chances from the outside and maybe a different look here for Don Gleason and his team. A strong serve taken by Califf. Near side and right down is Camden Gianni. Gianni, 13 kills yesterday. A little bit of a slow matchup against the Warriors of Merrimack. Only 6 kills on almost 20 attempts for Gianni. It really bounced back against the Crimson last night. Another one for Califf. And strongly set down by Arabaz, and it comes back for Schneider. And he'll put it away. The Lopes got flat-footed, but that one a nice setup by Sean Califf. Little finesse there at the net to keep it alive. Milligan back to serve. Milligan started in 23 of the 24 total matches a year ago. That one quickly put over. It was Slight trying to be deceptive. He'll go back row, and that one goes down for Hickman. Came right through the middle, and Hickman puts it down. The Jackson Hickman had a career high 19 kills against UC Irvine last February. Loves to play in the month of February. He's had some really good numbers. We'll see if that continues here today as that serve is going to land in. Gets a piece. You know, stats don't really separate much. Both teams with a couple of service errors. Kept alive. And the far side for Schneider. Tried to get it down, but he was blocked. Hickman again standing tall there at the front of the net. Jackson Hickman finding a groove during the couple of matches on the East Coast as that one's into the net by Carter Rogers. Give the point back to the Wildcats. Following that loss against Ohio State, who was ranked 5th at the time, Damon has picked up wins against AIC and Warner in clean sweeps. And that's a hold off UC Santa Barbara after winning the first two sets. They lost the next two. The fifth set thriller here in Cambridge last night is that one's going to go off the deflection. The point will stay with the Lopes. And Zach Schneider, who's back for his graduate year, ranked among NEC's leaders in a whole array of categories a year ago, including kills per set and fourth in hitting percentage in the conference last season. This time it comes to the near side and put down strongly by Billy Weberg. It's been fairly quiet here in the opening set, but gets a strong strike, goes cross court with it, and picks up a crucial point. Schneider will go back to serve, trailing by four here in the opening set. Set up by Slight, another strong strike from Carter Rogers. He puts that one down and hits inside the paint. So Carter Rogers finding some momentum here late in this first set. Two kills for Rogers, two for two on his attempts. That one's a low serve, comes back for Schneider. Kept alive off the dig, now Slight chases it down on the near side. Right back for Rogers, good dive there by Kruger. Sixth year for Kruger as this one's hit. Out of play. Michael Kruger, the graduate student from Canonsburg, Pennsylvania. Now playing in his sixth season of NCAA volleyball, all 6 years at Damon University. Back for Califf, who gets it off the block. It was tipped. Maverick O'Neill gets the point. Sean Califf has been smooth there at the net so far here early for the Wildcats. Trying to give this defense for GCU a couple of different looks. Slight now trying to set it up for Rogers again on the back row. And Kruger was there with Weberg, but both of them couldn't handle that one coming through from Rogers. Now 23-17 here in set number one. Long serve. Now set up here on the near side for Milligan, and he'll stop that run. Cameron Milligan gets up. Senior from New York. Was honored last year with second team all NEC performance. Was a three-time first point NEC prime performer a season ago. Made in 86 sets. Had a kill against Warner. It's a nice serve, a lot of spin on it. Now right back for Thorne, who gets the point. No, did he get a tip? It looked like he wanted the tip. Looked like GCU thought there might have been a tip there, but that one goes long, and the point goes to the Wildcats. So Kyle Zalesko on the service line, trying to string together a couple of points here for the Wildcats to stay in it in this opening set. So let's go to sophomore, gets another serve, overpass and sent right back. Another good read from the freshman Arabaz, who just takes advantage of the overpass, and GCU a couple of points now has made it a 3-point match. Lesko hits it into the net to stop the run. So that will give GCU the set point here in the opening set in Cambridge. Looks like they'll send in a serving specialist to go back and take this one to close it out. Jordan Lucas from Hacienda Heights, California, the sophomore in to serve. Moved into a service sub position in 2024. Courted an ace against UC San Diego. Played libero last season. This is on the back row and taken by the Wildcats. It was Schneider who tried to ride the line, but it was long and wide. And that's going to give Grand Canyon the opening set victory here to take a 1-0 lead over the fell in the semifinals to LIU. On the opposite side for Grand Canyon, they're also trying to build off of the success they had a year ago, a program-high 22 victories. They finished 6-6 in the MPSF, a quarterfinals victory against Pepperdine. They were fourth in the conference. They swept Pepperdine 3-0 before falling to UCLA in the semifinals. They earned an at-large bid to the tournament, as there's the first point there for GCU, and fell to Long Beach State. How about Long Beach State having a phenomenal year this season to get underway? up to number one in all the land. All 23 votes for Long Beach State for first place. A quick start here, 1-1 for set number two. Weber gets the kill. Set up to the back row again, and that's taken by Hickman. So Jackson Hickman, the senior, puts it down to take a one-point lead here in the second set. Hickman had a breakout season a year ago, earned all AVCA All-American honors, was listed to the second team, was a conference honorable mention in the MPSF. That one, a strong strike there from Schneider. He put a lot onto that one. Looked like his momentum was taking him backwards. Had to cock back the arm and still strike it and finding some space. First all-time meeting between GCU and Damon. Little push serve there. Set up to the backside. And on the dive, it's kept alive, but it's going to go out of play. A good hustle play on the far side by Maverick O'Neill. O'Neill just couldn't keep it on his side of the court. O'Neill appeared in 8 matches, played in 14 sets last season, getting more playing time this year here as a junior. That's going to ride the tape, get back over. Califf setting it up, and it's put right down by Arabaz. Arabaz, the freshman, looking forward to potentially playing professional volleyball later in his career. Out of the Czech Republic. Had 4 aces against AIC and 6 kills against Warner. Tells you up to 12th in the country in blocks per set now. Readjusting there was Carter Rogers. Just mistimed the jump, and now Schneider again has to reset. That opportunity kept alive. Arabaz gets it out to Milligan, but he hits the top of the tape, and it goes right back to the Wildcat side. 4-3 lead here for the Lopes. And both teams a little sloppy on that last sequence. Couldn't get anything clean. Rogers will go back to serve. Califf setting it back up for Schneider. Set for Slight, and Slight's going to set it up. That hits off the body of Califf, pushed over. And Milligan goes right into the net. Another point there for the Lopes. Cameron Milligan just couldn't stop his momentum from taking him through. Five-three lead here in set number two. Another strong serve taken by Weberg, and now a chance for Schneider off the block, but out of play. So Zach Schneider trying to get it off the block just enough. 5-4 lead as Damon cuts into it. GCU improving to 3-0 in neutral site games. They're 3-0 in away games. They're finding a way to win these matches away from home. That one's off the hands, off the dive. Good attempt. Good a diving attempt by Cooper Herndon, a junior from Dallas, Texas. Now Milligan will go back to serve. Point for GCU as they now take it 6-5 here in the second set. The service line proving to be one of the difference makers so far. 3 service aces for the Lopes, just 1 for the Wildcats, but service errors starting to pile up here for Damon. They're up to 6. That one off the block. Dorn got there. He got up for that one. Another chance on the far side for Weberg. Wardlow gets that one. Now right back. GCU out of sync, didn't have the bodies in the right position, and the Wildcats take advantage. It's going to lead to Arabaz going back to the service line. Been able to hold Camden Gianni in check so far. have the Wildcats. Another service error into the net from Arabaz. It's the seventh service error. Damon hitting 273 so far here in the second set. They're holding GCU to sub 200 at 143. Attempts so far here in the second set. Schneider back to serve. That one's strong, but it goes long from Zach Schneider. GCU will take the point and get back on serve. Good save there by Kruger, and that one's denied as Thorne got up, and then the strong hit. Another one long from the front row of Damon. So now it's Thorne and the blockers up front here for the Lopes, proving to make it more difficult for Damon up top. Another strong step at the overpass, and out of play it goes. Weberg was trying to take advantage of it. Now GCU with a three-point lead here in set number two. See if Don Gleason will take a timeout. They'll keep the guys out there. Good spin serve. Another set up for Weberg. And that's off the block, but out of play. Trying to get Billy Weberg, the junior, involved here, coming off the eight kills against Warner. Weberg with 12 kills last night, part of his double-double. First career double-double. That went into the net. Wildcats with 21 service errors last night against UC Santa Barbara. Well, that was a talking point for Don Gleason coming into today's matchup, cleaning up those service errors. Milligan. Denied by the block, and that one, another strong strike from Hickman. A little stare down after the play, and Cameron Hickman, number two UCLA last year in the season opener. Second matchup against a second-ranked team. We'll wrap up non-conference play with a matchup against American International College before starting NEC play. That one's kicked by Thorne to try to keep it alive, but right back down on the strike to get the point. Caleb just taking advantage. And Maverick O'Neill will go back to serve. Trying to get his team back in it. Trailing by three. O'Neill with a nice strike. Slight tries to set it up with the back set. Gianni with one more opportunity. Kept alive. Opportunity for Milligan. Good rally here, and that one's going to go into the net. Couldn't get it back over. Califf was right there. Now some different looks here from the Lopes. A lot of setups to the pin hitters, this time trying to go through the middle. And give the Wildcats a different look. Another strong serve, but it goes long there from Gianni. Gianni with a program record in aces. Trying to add to that tally. A nice powerful strike, but it just went too far. Now Sean Califf, a fifth year from Oak Park, Illinois. He'll try to match it, goes down the line. Off the block, and Kruger couldn't get there. Nice diving attempt from Michael Kruger. Just couldn't dig it out. Lopes add to their lead here in the second set. 4-point lead, 14-10. Kruger starts it off, and that one just pushed in. Weberg setting it up for Schneider. Now Slight looking near side. A little push over from Wardlow. Triple block keeps it alive, but it goes out of play. Hickman and Wardlow were there. It looked like it just hit off the hands of Rico Wardlow. And joined GCU after three seasons at Purdue Fort Wayne. Milligan gets the serve over. Another strong strike from Wardlow. And the senior gets back-to-back points here for the Lopes. One of two Lopes named to the All-MPSF second team last season. They'll go back to serve. Caleb now looking to try to get it through the middle. Another opportunity here for Hickman. That's off the hands of Wardlow, and he couldn't handle it. So a point back to the Wildcats. Dannon trying to stay in it here in this second set. Back to serve for Damon. Braden Winter is getting some action here, the freshman from Pennsylvania. Four-point lead regained here by GCU. ...17-12 here for GCU. Okay, back on the serve. Set up again for Weberg. Did he get it? Coming out of the timeout, it's going to be Nick Slight, junior from Storm Lake, Iowa. Trying to get us started here in the second. Weberg denied, but kept alive there by Califf. Far side for Snyder, gets it off the block. Way to keep it alive by Billy Weberg. And Zach Snyder stays with the play, puts it away. Reigning NEC Player of the Year, trying to keep the Wildcats in it here in set number two. He'll go back to serve. Slight comes near side for Gianni. No touch by Califf. Back-to-back points here for Damon. Looked like the Lopes were trying to get a touch there from the blockers, but it didn't come. Gets back to a four-point game. Another strong serve from Snyder. Set up here for Gianni. And a smart play there as he goes finesse over power and gets the point. Outside hitter now, Jackson Hickman. We'll go back to serve. Leading 19-14 here in the second set at the Malkin Athletic Center. And that one's just going to hit off the blockers and right back and out of play. Looks like Carter Rogers is trying to say it hit off the tape and back. Weberg's going to go back and get ready to serve this one. Damon just trying to go quickly. Looks like Lope still trying to plead their case. As Carter Rogers talking to the official. 20-14, GCU leading. Looks like they will take the point away from the Wildcats. Good pancake saved by Kruger. Going back for Weberg, tries to put it over the block. They say the pancake didn't come. Kruger didn't get the hand down. Now 21-14 here in set number two. GCU trying to run away with it. A strong serve. Kruger handles it nicely. Back for Weberg, and he's denied. It's Thorne. Had Gianni alongside, but Cameron Thorne puts it right back. Already making an instant impact on the season as a sophomore. Weberg gets low. Back set here for Schneider. Off the block and out of play. So Wildcats stay in it here in the second set. Another chance for Billy Weberg. Near side for Carter Rogers. Gets it off the hands of Califf and Maverick O'Neill. 2 points away from claiming the second set. GCU leads it 23-15. Good movement of the ball here in the second set as that one's just going to be mishit by Thorne on the serve. Sixth service error for GCU. Now coming back in is Kyle Zelasko. Picked up two aces against Warner. Tries to serve down the line. Kept alive there. Wardlow gets it. Off the feed from Slight. That's going to give GCU a set point here in set number two. Wardlow now up to four kills, hitting 333 in today's match. Camden Gianni on the service line. That one's pushed over, fisted towards the front. Slight to the near side for Rogers, and Carter Rogers puts it down and claims set number two. The Lopes hit 409 in the second set to take. They're starting 6-0, we're listed as number two in the January rankings. Just behind Long Beach State, ahead of Hawaii, Stanford, and Powerhouse UCLA. Ohio State's having a great year as that one's going to go wide. Point there for the Lopes. Penn State, usually the powerhouse out of the EIVA. Princeton also to a great start. They picked up a win against UC Santa Barbara as that serve goes into the net. So we're tied at 1-1. Now after 19 road matches last year for the Lopes, they'll hit the road for a majority of their matches this year as well, including this six-game road trip, three on the East Coast. 15 of their 25 regular season matches will come on the road as that one is hit off the hands. And now another point for the Wildcats. They'll go as far east as here in Cambridge, Mass. And then go as far west as Hawaii. Just under 15,000 miles traveled on the year for the Lopes. Another point for GCU. They're playing the Outrigger Invitational, hosted by Hawaii. And their conference games will take them all across the West Coast. On the near side for Milligan. It was jousted for there at the net, but right back down. Gianni with the stronger hands gets the point. And 4-0 on the season when leading by 2-0 for GCU. As that one goes into the net. There's Jackson Hickman on the serve. Two All-Americans on the preseason off-the-block All-American team in Gianni and Nick Slight. Back set here, taken by Gianni, and he'll get the point. So Camden Gianni puts GCU ahead here in the third set. The thing about this GCU team is they've gotten help from Cameron Thorne. Rico Wardlow continues his hot start. 547 hit percentage as Schneider gets the point there for the Wildcats. Zach Schneider trying to build off of his campaign a year ago where he broke Damon's single season kills record with 318, broke the kills record in four sets, had 23 in the matchup against St. Francis last April. Also had the record for a three-set match kills with 19. That's kept alive. Now Slight looking for Wardlow. Just pushed it too far to the left. No, he actually got a tip. So the point will go to GCU. Looked like it just landed wide, but got a tip there from the block up top. Schneider ranking third in NEC in points with 4.46 points per set. Gonna try to keep that going this year as there's another serve into the net. You're in the third set. Grand Canyon making some mental mistakes, keeping Damon in it. So another service error. Five kills leading the charge for Milligan. A service error gives the point right back. So 25 kills in total in the match for GCU. Schneider is 9 for 18, hitting 278. Billy Wieberg picking up the kill on that last play. All tied at 6-6 here in the third set. Andre Arabaz, the freshman, back to serve. Slight back set, sets it up for Gianni. His tip now played here on the near side, looking for Wieberg. Hit it long. He was looking for a chance to get some fingertips off the GCU block, but didn't get it. Lopes trying to hold off the Wildcats here in the third set, ahead 7-6. Hitting just under 400 at 396. Four aces in the match. Back on the near side for Wieberg, and he puts it down. Billy Wieberg trying to stop this run for GCU and keep the Wildcats in it. He does a good job there by going cross court and finding an opening. Schneider back to serve. Slight looking back to the front of the net. Got it off the block, but kept alive by Milligan. Good effort by Kruger. Little back dunk there by Wieberg, but no touch. It goes out of play. And the point to the Wildcats. They take the lead 8-7 here in the third set. Little different look from Billy Wieberg on the flip there at the net, keeping the point alive on the far side and forcing the mistake from GCU. Another powerful serve from Schneider goes to Hickman. Played on the back row by Gianni. Catches the piece of the line. Milligan thought it was just going to go long, but Gianni with some nice English on that one gets the point. Light trying to catch the line, but it goes long on the service error. We told you about the All-Americans on the Lopes. They return four AVCA All-Americans in Camden Gianni and Jackson Hickman. Nick Slight getting the nod, and Rico Wardlow as well. That's another strong hit, but Wieberg on the back row saves that one. Now Milligan denied, and Kruger couldn't bury it back up. So back and forth we go here in the third set between Damon and GCU. Hickman on the serve. Coming off career highs in almost every statistical category a year ago. Another point for the Lopes. ...10-9 lead here for GCU as Hickman remains on the serve. Near side for Milligan, it's right back down. Gianni and Thorne were there. Looked like Thorne got the majority of it. Camden Gianni spent this past summer with Team USA at the Pan American Cup. Played in the Pan American Six. In his second stint with Team USA, capturing gold for the first time at the Pan Am Six. Finished in fifth place at the Pan Am Cup, collecting 53 total kills across five starts. And led Team USA with 18 points in the group stage, with the win over the Dominican Republic. Getting some good experience. That one's off the tape and back. 13th service error on the night here for Damon. They've limited it from a night ago or last night where they had 21, 13, much better pace than they were last night against UC Santa Barbara. That one's a strong hit, but it goes long from Schneider. Now a 3-point lead here for the Lopes. Well, they continue to build strong non-conference matchups. Damon's trying to continue to play these tough opponents. At number 5, Ohio State on their schedule, 2 ranked opponents here at the Harvard Invitational, and have a chance to really build their resume in conference play. 11 wins a year ago with the NEC. Califf now. Nice drop serve. Slide to the back row, taken by Hickman. And Hickman does it again, this time just hitting the body. The senior puts GCU on top by 3. ...14-11 here in the third set for the Lopes. On the near side, taken strong hit. Hickman trying to get it over. Overpass is taken advantage by Milligan. Got up for that one, put it down as GCU was all out of sorts. Milligan now back to serve, trailing by 2 here in the third. Slight looks back row again, gets Gianni. Good dig by Califf. Cross court hit, Slight goes far side, taken by Rogers off the block. But it looks like Rogers went into the net, so a net violation. And Damon within 1 after trailing by 4 here in this third set. Milligan back on the service line. Strong serve again. Slight going for Rogers. Rogers gets the cross court strike. Oh, they needed a hot hand last night. They went to Carter Rogers. Here tonight, they do it again. And the junior gets the cross court point to put GCU back on top by 2. Overpass and taken by Hickman. That's the danger of just 2 at 8 p.m. So stay with us here at the Cameron or the Mulkin Athletic Center in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Number 2, Grand Canyon, trying to remain undefeated and pick up their 2nd invitational victory of the season after winning the A6 Invitational earlier this year, hosted by UC Santa Barbara. Trying to claim the Harvard Invitational here on the East Coast. GCU improving to 3-1 all time against the Crimson with the victory last night. There's Schneider trying to put an end to that GCU run. Remains a 3-point game, 17-14. Matt Worley looking for his 137th victory in his coaching career. Arabaz back to serve here for the Wildcats. Looks like we got a service violation as Arabaz went over the line. GCU now with the point, 18-14. For a majority of this third set, Damon was able to hold the Lopes to sub 200 hit percentage, but now GCU back up over 300 at 308 currently. That's off the body of Rogers. A good point there by Billy Weberg. GCU hasn't been quite able to pull away here in the third. Damon has kept it interesting within arm's reach. Another one that rides the tape, but it goes wide. They're on the serve. Snyder thought it landed in. Now 19-15. 15 service errors for Damon. On the near side for Weberg, got it off the block. Kept alive by Herndon, and then put down by Hickman. Got Sean Caleb to bite, went a little too aggressive, so he goes cross court and gets the point to open up a 5-point lead here in this third set. Five-point match here in the third set between GCU and Damon. Wildcats need a comeback to extend this match. Awaiting the officials to check the lineup cards, make sure everyone's good. Before we get underway here, following the timeout from Damon. Kept alive by Milligan on the push and denied. Did it get a piece of the line on the far side? It did, as Hickman put a lot of power behind that one. 6-point lead here for GCU. Milligan overpass on the play, and now it's Thorne who puts it down. Cameron Thorne. Well, if you thought his freshman year was great, his sophomore year is off with a bang. Already putting some kills down in some crucial moments. Third kill of the match for Cameron Thorne. Another overpass, but it's played and unable to get the dive there with Schneider. 23-15 as Grand Canyon trying to put this one away. Slight over hits the serve. That one goes out of play. Still some life here for the Wildcats. Weberg back to serve. Nice serve there by Weberg as he gets the ace. Back-to-back points here for Damon. We'll try to ride the hot hand here on Billy Weberg. Overpass on the serve reception. Taken and flipped over there by Maverick O'Neill. Three straight points for the Wildcats. Not going to go away quietly. We saw it last night against UC Santa Barbara. 23-18 here in the third. Weberg, another strong serve. High setup, it's gonna be over and now taking advantage. That time was Milligan. Slight going for Gianni, and Gianni gets the tip at the top. Match point coming for Grand Canyon. ...24-18 here in the third set. The Lopes trying to claim the title at the Harvard Invitational with a victory here against Damon. That's a service error there by Hickman. So they'll play it off the Damon serve here at 24-19. For GCU, looks like a serve specialist is going to come in. It's going to be Kyle Zelasco coming back in for the third time today. Ranked second in the NEC in service aces a year ago with 29. Can he extend the match here for the Wildcats? Hits it off the tape, set back by Slight. Now Zelasco punches it up. Schneider had to readjust, but he hits it into the net. And the Grand Canyon Antelopes are your Harvard Invitational champs with a clean sweep over Damon and last night over Harvard University. The Lopes now improved to 9-0 and remain undefeated on the season. A lot of